In this video, I'm going to quickly walk you through setting up WireGuard on your desktop PC and a remote server. This will allow you to securely access your desktop GPU from a web server to make API calls. At the end of the video, I will demo this with a chatbot website on a remote server powered by my local Oobabooga instance. I use ChatGPT to help write a guide, so you can copy and paste these same commands. Look in the video description. In order to configure WireGuard, you will first need to create a set of keys on both your desktop and remote server. The commands from ChatGPT didn't quite work on my first try. I needed to become root with sudo su to enter the WireGuard directory before the keys could be generated. Remember to exit root when you no longer need those privileges. ChatGPT gave me a good starting point for the configuration files. In most cases, I would expect that you could copy and paste these configuration files, only needing to substitute the keys and the static IP address of your server. If you run into a problem with these settings, I would recommend having ChatGPT help you rewrite them. Here I will show the configuration files side by side. I have given my desktop PC the IP address 10.0.1.1 and my remote server the IP address 10.0.1.2. These IP addresses are used internally, they are not your public IP addresses. Your static public IP address is your remote server's IP address. Since your desktop IP address is dynamic, there is no endpoint in the server configuration file. Now, run this command on both the desktop and server. Then reboot both computers to check the connection. Please note, when you reboot your desktop PC, you will need to restart the connection by pinging the server from the desktop. I have provided a script to periodically ping the server from the desktop after the desktop first boots up and establishes an internet connection. This way you stay connected even when your dynamic IP changes on your desktop. You can find the script, as well as the rest of the commands seen in this video in the video description. If you watch the video closely, you might notice a discrepancy. When I first started to make this video, I was using 10.0.0.1 as my desktop IP address. This was the same subnet as my default network. This meant that due to the WireGuard configuration, all of my web browsing and internet was routed through my remote server. By changing to the 10.0.1.0 subnet on both desktop and server, I was not able to receive API calls to my desktop from my remote server while using my home internet connection as normal on my desktop. Since I'm assuming that this is the behavior most people would prefer by default, the commands in the video description have been changed to reflect this. If everything worked, you should have a permanent connection between your desktop and remote server, and your remote server should be able to now make secure API calls utilizing your local GPU. To test that everything is working, I will SSH into my server. Then I will ping the desktop and reboot it. Agnaistic is running on my server. I want to power it with Oobabooga. It seems like the ShareLink API is not working with this program. Even if the standard Oobabooga API did work, I usually prefer the cobbled EI API. Oobabooga runs COBOL DI API with IPI flag, but it doesn't work with share flag. Although I wouldn't be surprised if this is changed by the time you watch this video. With this setup, I can drop the share flag by using the internal IP address and endpoint. Just by using the flags, listen and EPI, Agnaistic will have access to the COBOL DI API. In this case, I am putting the URL endpoint under the COBOL DI settings, even though I am running text in Oobabooga. Like I mentioned before, I am emulating the COBOL DI API since it tends to be more stable.